Pat, that turned out to be a great performance from the guys tonight. How did it look from the side?
It looked very good. You know, the team stuck to the game plan, and they didn't stray from that, and that's something that we've been working on, and obviously it worked out.
Yeah, they took the game to us for a good 2.5 periods there. What do you think turned the game around there for us?
Just like I said, sticking the system, that's something that Coach Hutchins has been stressing to us. We can't stray and try to do individual things. We got to stick to a team, play our system, and eventually we can we get back into the games.
Big performances tonight from Doug, who's slotted into the role and played huge performances for us during your absence. And, of course, obviously, Rio Pell as well.
Yeah, all the guys have been doing extremely well. I know we got a couple banged up more bodies inside, and, you know, Dougie's playing with a broken toe. So that's just a testament to his character, and I think the rest of the team just follows suit.
How difficult is it for you, Pat, standing and watching that?
It's extremely difficult. The past three games, you know, you don't want to sit outside the rink, and you want to be in there with your teammates getting into it. So hopefully I'll be back in the next couple of days.
Good stuff. What do you make of the last 7 minutes of the game? I mean, it was a bit chaotic. I mean, it's hard to put a finger on, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it just got a little bit out of hand. But like I said, the guys stuck to the system and everyone stuck together as a team. And that's what you need to do in a game like that.
Sunday coming up, huge game against Brayhead. You're going to be back for that?
I believe so, yeah, hopefully.
Good stuff. Yeah. Thanks for your time, Pat.
All right, thank you.
Cheers, mate. AJ, half-time, we're in a good position.
Yeah, it's. I think if you would have told us we're going to be 4-2 up, well, we're going to take it. But by no means are we anywhere close to being finished. Sheffield's a terrific side. They came at us all night. And, you know, if it wasn't for some timely saves by Rio and some timely scoring, I think it could have been a different game. So by no means are we satisfied.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, for 2.5 years, this kept continuously coming at us and coming at us. You know, and then it all changed in the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, they have a lot of depth and they use it well. They skate really well, they forecheck well, and they came at us. There's not really much more I can say than we had timely saves and timely scoring, and that was the tail of the tape, I think.
Yeah. A huge result for us, you know. Fans, probably one of the lowest crowds we've had here this year, yeah, but the fans did get behind us for sure in the last 10 minutes. That must have made a big difference.
Yeah, it's always great when the old Dundee faithful get going back there and the drums start going. I think we all enjoy it and we all appreciate it, so... all I can say is keep it up, guys. It's been great.
Good. One final thing, just a quick one, about your dad and his doppelganger. Tell us a bit about that.
I only know as much as everyone else does. I seen a couple tweets about it, and I kind of woke up. My phone was blown up with all these pictures and emails of it. So it was kind of funny. I got a quick chat with him about it. He just kind of had a chuckle. So it's all in good fun, I guess.
Good stuff. Big game against Brayhead coming up, AJ, on Sunday. Every bit as big as tonight's, you know.
Yeah, they don't get any smaller now. They just keep getting bigger. So we have a day tomorrow that we can either, you know, it's kind of if you got a little bumps and bruise, you can rest. If you want to go on the ice and get a sweat, you can. Get our minds back straight and on Brayhead. So.
AJ, thanks for your time.
Anytime.
Great result.
Thank you.
Hi, mate. Jeff, that was hard work tonight, but what a tremendous performance in the end by the guys.
Yeah, I think obviously, you know, our first two periods, I think we were fortunate to be down 2-1. I think they played hard and they came at us. And, you know, I think our game plan was just to, you know, clog up the middle and try to take away their speed. And I think we did, for the most part, did a good job at that. I think they scored, you know, off a couple rushes. And you know, I think overall, I think the first two periods, I think, you know, I wasn't overly pleased with how we played. But this competition's not about you know, about winning one game. It's about winning six periods. And I think you know, in the third period, I think we came out and we did a job to put ourselves in a great position going into the fourth period.
Absolutely. You know, yeah, as you say, Jeff, it's only half time. And that looked like a Sheffield side that were much improved from the last time they were here.
Yeah, I mean, there's no question they've got a lot of depth. They've, you know, they've got three lines and you know, a very quality Brit sitting as their 10. So, yeah, I think we did well to try to match up the lines and try to get, you know, the matchups we wanted out there. And, you know, our big line came through with three timely goals, and then you know, our second line chipped in with one tonight. And it's good that we start mixing the scoring around. And, you know, our D-Cor and Rio, I think, have been really good lately, and I'm quite pleased with the performance in the third.
Got to be a big shout out to the penalty kill tonight again, Jeff. That was awesome in the last period.
Yeah, I think obviously, I think, you know, there was a lot of stuff let go on both sides. I think, you know, either team can't really complain about the calls or non-calls. I think, you know, I think it was pretty even on both sides. I think, you know, we got a little bit, you know, we were in a situation where we were a couple guys down and we dug deep. And, you know, it's great. It's good that we have a two-goal lead going into the fourth period. I think, you know, it's gonna be tough down there, and we're gonna have to rise to the challenge. And I think it's a big step forward for our club. I think you know, we have that winning attitude now, and you know, we're working hard every day. And it, you know, if we improve a little bit every day, at the end of the year, we'll be in a good place.
Good. It's just a pity that there was a few fans there tonight to see it. You know, it's probably one of our worst crowds of the year, and that's probably, you know, understandable, yeah. Given the situation. But the guys, you know, turned up the volume in the last 10 minutes for you, for sure.
Yeah, I think, obviously, it's a Thursday night game. You know, it's tough to pull the crowd on a Thursday night. You know, and it's also you know, tough financially for people this time to make commitment to two games in a week is a, you know. So those fans that did make it, you know, I'm very grateful that they were, you know, spurred us on at the end there. And those that didn't make it, I know they were supporting us in one way or the other.
Good. Big game coming up again. It doesn't get any easier, you know, probably in a bigger game, you know, with the Brayhead Clan here on Sunday. Have we got a fit squad? Is Pat likely to be back?
Well, I don't really like to comment on injuries. You know, we'll assess whatever injuries we have on the team, and we'll move forward into Sunday's game. I think the thing I told the guys after this one is enjoy the position we're in at the moment, but our next goal is to be in first place in the conference by the end of the weekend. You know, and that's, you know, that's our goal, and that was our goal from the beginning of the year, and that's what we need to focus on.
Jeff, thanks for your time. A great performance, and well done.
Thank you very much.